You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I am your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is well known all over the world to celebrate a number of cultural and traditional festivals which have their own unique history, legend and significance of celebration. So, today we take you to witness the vibrant celebrations of Janmashtami, one of the major Hindu festivals that was recently celebrated with huge pomp and show across the country. Krishna Janmashtami is one of the major festivals in India that was celebrated recently with great zeal and enthusiasm in different parts of the country. Marking the birth anniversary of Lord Krishna, this religious festival is celebrated on the Ashtami of Krishna Paksh, or the 8th day of the dark fortnight in the month of Bhado, according to Hindu calendar. Though the festival was celebrated with much fervor all over the world, Mathura, being the birthplace of Lord Krishna, celebrated the occasion with unmatched zeal and grandeur. The city witnessed a huge rush with people thronging the temples to have just one glimpse of Lord Krishna and seek his blessings.
यहाँ के माहौल इतनी अच्छी है कि हर कोई आना चाहता है। इसके दर्शन को मन्नत इतनी पूरी होती है कि सब लोग चाहते हैं कि सारे मन्नत पूरी करें।
माहौल यहाँ का बहुत ही अच्छा है और बहुत ही यानी मैं कहूँगा कि दिव्य है और काफी यानी यहाँ की जो श्रद्धालु हैं श्रद्धालु में काफी दिव्यता का मुझे एहसास हो रहा है।
With the devotees performing dance and chanting the Maha Mantra of Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, SCON Temple at Delhi also came alive with the auspicious festivities of Janmashtami. Scores of devotees flocked to temple from various corners of the country to celebrate the birth of Lord Krishna and witness the rituals and ceremonies performed here. Adorned with traditional jewelry and new clothes, the idols of Lord Krishna and Radha were given ritualistic bath with milk and curd. Meanwhile, in India's western Mumbai city, youngsters filled with joy and enthusiasm took part in Dahi Handi, a sport where participants form human pyramids in order to break decorated clay pots full of curd hung high above them. It is an event imitating one of the popular acts of Krishna's young life, as he is believed to have been fond of butter, curd and other dairy products.
दरअसल हम लोग बहुत इंतजार करते हैं धरेंडी का और ये साल हम लोग डबल जोश से आए
इन वडोदरा सिटी ऑफ गुजरात गर्ल्स एंड बॉयज ड्रेस्ड इन कलरफुल ट्रेडिशनल क्लोथ्स डांस्ड ऑन द ट्यून्स ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल कृष्णा सॉन्ग्स एंड लेटर टुक पार्ट इन द मटकी फोर्ट विद मच जॉय एंड ज़ी The cradle with the idols of Krishna placed in it was then rocked while the devotees chanted prayers and sang hymns. Also, dressed in yellow clothes, girded with golden bands, a crown on the head and colorful peacock feather on its top, Many little Krishnas also rocked the cradle, presenting a feast to the eyes of the viewers.
मटकी फोड़ी और कृष्ण भगवान को झूला भी झुलवाया गरबा किया और बहुत मजे किए हम
सब. According to Hindu scriptures, Lord Krishna took birth in human form to kill Kans, demon king of Mathura city and maternal uncle of Lord Krishna. Thus, the festival of Janmashtami holds a great significance in the lives of people, as it also teaches us how to fight evil and falsehood and establish truth.
India has always been a land of great saints, assimilating in its fold various cultures and thoughts from time to time. It is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. A glimpse of it can be very well witnessed in the dargahs of the Sufi saints. So, today we take you to one such dargah in Karnataka that has been for long acting as a bridge between different castes and communities.
Located in the Kalaburgi district of Karnataka, the dargah of Hazrat Khwaja Banda Nawaz Gesu Daraz is one of the most revered Sufi shrines in the country. Said to be a famous Sufi saint of the Chishti order, Gesu Daraz was the disciple of the noted Sufi saint of Delhi, Nasiruddin Chirag Dehlavi, after whose death he took over the mantle of the successor. Born in Delhi in 1321, he shifted to Maharashtra along with his family at the age of 4, and in 1397 he went to Kalaburgi at the invitation of Sultan Tajuddin Firuz Shah. There he spread Sufism and advocated understanding, tolerance and harmony among various religious groups, making him respected by one and all.
آج سے تقریباً 650 سال پہلے حضرت خواجہ گیسو دراز بندہ نواز رحمت اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ نے اسی پیغام کو لے کر نکلا اور ہمارے نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے پیغام کو عام کیا کہ آپس میں اخوت، محبت، اتحاد، رواداری کے ساتھ ملک میں رہیں اور ملک سے محبت بھی ایمان کی علامت ہے.
یہاں پر دیش کا جو سیکولرزم ہے وہ سیکولرزم آپ کو اگر کہیں پہ دیکھنے ملتا ہے تو ہندوستان کی بارگاہوں میں دیکھنے ملتا ہے، چاہے وہ اجمیر شریف کی بارگاہ ہو یا ہندوستان کے بندہ نواز رحمت اللہ علیہ کرناٹکا کی بارگاہ ہو یا کسی بھی ہندوستان کی بارگاہ ہو، آپ کو سیکولرزم جو ہے جس کے بیس کے اوپر ہندوستان ٹھہرا ہے وہ بیس بارگاہوں میں دیکھنے میں ملتا ہے.
Thronged by the people across religious faiths, the Dargah of Gesu Daraz is a wonderful example of Indo-Saracenic style of architecture. It has been playing a significant role in spreading Sufism, just like the Dargahs in other parts of the country.
ہندوستان میں قومی یکجہتی کو اگر کسی نے متعارف کروایا، انٹروڈیوس کروایا، تو وہ صوفیاء کرام ہے. ہندوستان میں صوفیاء کرام نے سب سے پہلے ہندو مسلم یکجہتی اور ایکتا کو شروع کیا، اور آج بھی ان کے آستانوں میں ہندو مسلم ایکتا دکھائی دیتی ہے. ہندوستان میں جو کشمیر ہے، جس کو ہندوستان کا تاج کہا جاتا ہے، وہاں بھی کئی عظیم صوفیاء آرام فرما ہے اور ان کے آستانے آج بھی ہندو مسلم ایکتا کے مراکز ہیں.
The message of peace and brotherhood come out loud from the dargahs of Sufi saints. Visited by the people irrespective of their religion, they have been acting as symbols of communal harmony for ages.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Indian statue market can be seen flooded with eco-friendly idols of Hindu elephant god Ganesha ahead of his 10-day birth celebration festivities. According to tradition, Hindus bring Ganesha idols to home on his birthday, and after 10 days of festivities with his favorite sweets and dance and decorations, they send him off with huge processions and immerse the idols in water bodies. With several awareness programs, the demand for eco-friendly idols are on rise, and the Indian market is complying.
காகித கொள்வினாயகர்ங்கிறது வந்து கிழங்கு மாவு பசை ஓடக்கல் மாவு பேப்பர் தூள் வச்சு தயார் பண்ணுறோம். இந்த சிலைகள்னால சுற்றுப்புற சூழலில் எந்த பாதிப்பும் ஏற்படாது, நீர்நிலையில் எளிதில் கரைஞ்சிரும். அதுபோக அந்த வண்ணங்கள் வந்து டிஸ்டம்பர் கலர்னால அது சுண்ணாம்பு கலவை தான், அதனால் வந்து நீர்நிலைகளுக்கும் அந்த மீன்களுக்கும் அது எந்த பாதிப்பும் ஏற்படாதுங்கிறது.
Similarly, in southern Karnataka state, an activist and idol maker has made idols out of paper pulp and recycled paper with vegetables and fruit seeds in it. So, when people do the immersion ritual in a pot instead of a water body, a plant will grow out of it. A team of scientists from Pune city in Maharashtra have developed a technology which could detect cancer at an early stage. The new technology, which the scientists have termed as OncoDiscover, is developed by a team led by Dr. Jayant Khandare, who claims that the technology can help establish the overall survival rate of cancer patients. It can speed up cancer detection process, as the old technology takes 12 days for development of final diagnosis report of detection of cancer, whereas the new technology can detect the same in 3.5 hours.
तीन बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव्स और एडवांटेजेस इस टेक्नोलॉजी के हैं, इस प्लेटफॉर्म के, कि आप डिटेक्ट करते हैं, डायग्नोसिस करते हैं, आप एक्चुअली पेशेंट का ड्रग रिस्पॉन्स देख पाएंगे, प्रोग्नोस्टिक्स आप एक्चुअली इसको वैल्यू मान जाते हैं. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि जो पेशेंट डिसीज प्री है, जो रिलैप्स मोड में आ सकते हैं. सो कैंसर में क्वाइट ऑफन बोला जाता है व्हाट गोज अराउंड विल कम अराउंड और एवरीथिंग इज रिटन इन द ब्लड. तो ये मार्कर जो है कैंसर ट्यूमर सेल्स का, हम ये बहुत पहले देख पा सकते.
According to National Institute of Cancer Prevention and Research, cancer is the second most common cause of death in India, and 784,821 people died in the country due to cancer in 2018. India's cabinet recently approved further liberalizing of foreign direct investment rules in four sectors in an effort to get economic growth back on track. The government approved foreign investment in digital media up to stakes of 26%, allowed 100% foreign investment for coal mining, associated infrastructure and sales of fuel. Till now, foreign investment was only allowed in coal mines allotted for captive use, meaning for use by the companies themselves. The new mining investment policy will open up investment avenues for companies like Peabody, Glencore and BHP Group Limited.
अब डिसाइड किया है कि शत प्रतिशत FDI ऑटोमेटिक रूप में कोल माइनिंग और उसके सेल के लिए पूरी जो एक्टिविटीज लगती हैं, जो भी एसोसिएटेड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर लगता है, उस सभी कामों के लिए शत प्रतिशत FDI कोल माइनिंग में अलाउ किया जाए.
न्यू दिल्ली आल्सो अलाउड 100% फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट इन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड ईज सोर्सिंग नॉर्म्स फॉर सिंगल ब्रांड रिटेलर्स. द गवर्नमेंट इवन सेड that single brand retail firms would be permitted to open online stores before setting up bricks and mortar stores, making it easier for firms like Apple, which do not operate retail stores in the country, to start selling their products online.
Japan believes in development while keeping its traditions intact. Japan's capital, Tokyo, recently hosted the World Sushi Chef competition to promote the country's sushi culture. Meanwhile, Tomisato, a town in Chiba Prefecture of Japan, organized a traditional watermelon road race.
Sushi is one of the staple dishes of Japan. It is prepared by arranging various ingredients on a plate to create themes. World Sushi Cup Japan 2019 was recently held in Tokyo. This competition was held to improve the skill of sushi chefs around the world and promote sushi culture of Japan. 20 chefs from various regions and countries participated in it. In the competition, one of the judges was Mr. Daisuke Terasawa, who is a comic artist of Shota na Sushi, which depicts the life of a sushi chef. Cartoons and dramas have introduced sushi culture to young Japanese people. Recently, cartoons have widely introduced Japanese sushi culture overseas through publication and broadcasting dramas. The winner of the competition was Mr. Yap Wee Leong from Malaysia, who is a young sushi chef. His generation of sushi chefs love to watch comic and TV drama of Shota no Sushi, and this is what that provoked him to be a world top sushi chef. Next, we take you to Tomisato, a town in the Chiba Prefecture of Japan. Well known for growing high-quality watermelons, Tomisato has been holding this running festival for the last 36 years to celebrate the red fruit's harvest. Visitors from all across Japan come to Tomisato to run and eat watermelon at this festival.
ここはですね、富里の名産でありますスイカをメインにしたロードレースになっておりまして、通常給水所、水とかスポーツドリンクを置いてあるんですけども、その第5給水所にスイカを置いてありまして、それを皆さん食べながらレースに参加していただく。で、レースが終わった後にこのような形でスイカを皆さんで無料で食べていただくような、そのようなロードレース大会になっております。
Some runners and spectators took full advantage of the watermelon theme by dressing in green, red, and black. Despite the discomfort, runners bravely put on their best impression of a watermelon. Like the unique costumes, Tomisato's watermelons have a unique history.
Tomisato's history is in the 天皇に献上して、はい、でそれ以来ですね、富里が一応このスイカの産地になったっていうか、経緯があります。今全体富里市で行くと大体350件ほどあるのかな、はい。まあ、面積っていうか、その行くと大体250兆分ぐらいの面積があるっていうか。
The running festival is a way for the local agricultural setup to showcase the year's harvest and sell watermelon to tourists coming to participate in the road race. many participants were looking quite interested in the all-you-can-eat watermelon provided at the end of the race. Some runners also brought the watermelon back to their home as a souvenir. The race has different levels to suit all age groups, making it a family-friendly event. Children and adults competed in different competitions. Winners received a figurine symbolizing the Tomisato road race named Tomichan. The town will continue to promote a healthy lifestyle of exercise and nutrition through their mascot Tomichan.
Jammu and Kashmir is an epitome of brotherhood, with different communities residing together with complete harmony. People here not just remain together during the times of joy, but also stay beside each other during sorrows. A glimpse of it was witnessed in the Pulwama district when people from Muslim community helped in performing the last rites of a Kashmiri Pandit.
It is said that if we love all religions equally, then there will be no incident of conflicts. These words were recently proved right during the funeral of a Kashmiri Pandit, Ratan Lal, when his Muslim neighbors gathered at his residence in Muran village of Pulwama to perform his last rites. Around 2,000 in number, they not just provided their condolences to the Lal's family, but also did all the arrangements of his funeral, that too in accordance with Hindu rituals, setting a great example of communal harmony.
We believe in communal harmony, we believe in love, we believe in fraternity, we believe in brotherhood. Khaskar main to bolta hu yahi ki insaan ka koi dar mazhab nahi hota hai na to dosti ka koi dharm hota hai.
Besides doing all the arrangements, they even helped the Lal's family in carrying his body to the cremation pyre. One among the few Kashmiri Pandit families who decided to stay back during the tumultuous years of 90s when all Pandits were leaving the region, Lal's family seems to have got the reward of their courage. Today, all their Muslim neighbors are standing by them at their difficult times, no matter which community they belong to.
हम यहीं रहते थे, हम यहाँ से कभी नहीं निकले, हम 6-7 घर यहाँ पर रहते हैं, बहुत अच्छी तरह से रहते हैं, जो हमारे मुसलमान भाई हैं, जो भी गांव के, यहाँ गांव के नहीं, पूरे इलाके के कल लोग मेरे आगे मेरे फादर के जो अख्ती रसूमात थे.
It's due to the efforts of one family who showed courage at the time when others decided to quit, we got to witness such a beautiful example of love and brotherhood.
India had always been known as the land that portrayed cultural and traditional vibrancy through its conventional arts and crafts. Every region here has its own style and pattern of art, popularly known as folk art, which is very ethnic and simple, yet colourful and vibrant enough to speak volumes about country's rich heritage. So, today we take you to the Bhubaneswar city of Odisha, where several initiatives are being taken by the state departments to promote the rich folk art forms. Have a look.
With over 400 folk arts and as many as 800 art groups and more than 1 lakh folk artists, Odisha is a hub of the most exquisite art and craft. But with time, these art forms are dying a slow death. So providing them with a new lease of life, the Culture Department of Odisha has decided to organize an event named Ammo Loka Kala, Ammo Sanskruti, every month, in which 2 to 3 performances will take place. One such event was recently organized in the Bhubaneswar city. The main motive behind this initiative is to sensitize the people of Odisha about the folk art form of the state, along with helping the new generation to stay connected with their roots.
It is really interesting, this type of arts which are gradually dying. We can say that dying art, performance of dying arts, we never see in this platform like capital of Odisha, that is Bhubaneswar. It is usually performed by the artist in the regional area, in the local area where they inhabits. But the culture department having their own effort, they in each month and a particular day, they are trying to show this arts, the folk arts, folk dance, folk songs, and tribal arts and tribal songs.
Similar initiatives are also taken by the Odisha's Textile and Handloom Department to promote the local handloom products, along with providing a promotional and marketing support to weavers of the state. A special handloom expo organized in Bhubaneswar was one among them, in which as many as 30 leading primary weavers cooperative societies of the state participated.
Odisha's handloom legacy, this textile and all, itna enriched है. We have lot of weavers, बहुत सारे weavers है, जो design वो produce कर रहे हैं, वो unique है. Even you won't find in other states also. These are all additional events which gives a platform to these people to showcase their products, showcase their talents, and to get exposure to lot of people.
With such initiatives taken by the state departments to promote the folk art and culture will not only help in uplifting the economic condition of the artists of Odisha, but also keep the art preserved for centuries.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.